topic of this event is very timely and very quickly. Oppression and repression.
What we're saying is there are white people in the mother country that are for the same type of thing.
We have to go to the root. We have to go
to
the cause.
I don't know what will happen now. We've got some difficult days ahead. But it really doesn't matter what's going on.
Confronting is the problem of racism.
We are oppressed. We are exploited. We are downtrodden. We are denied not only civil rights, but even human rights. So the only way we're going to get some of this oppression and exploitation away from us or aside from us is come together against the common enemy.
We started up SCAN, scanning school kids against the Nazis. To the idea of the National Front in it, and we want to sort of stop it at the beginning at schools in it.
All the racism and all this, because most fights which happen in school are caused by racism, right? It's not just by jealousy or hate or something which crops up between them. It's mostly racism, and you mostly find all the fights going between two different races. And the headmistress constantly keeps on saying that, you know, let's be one big happy family. Yeah. It's really depressing. It is.
I don't think a lot of them bit is that because they're haters or anything, but when they're unemployed, they decide to blame it on us.
I just think the National Front wants someone to
pick on
for what's happening to the country at the moment.
They don't just want someone to hold the can for them.
Teaching our school, they don't talk about the National Front. They think it's going to go away if we don't talk about it. And no, it's silly because it won't go away. It's going to be there. It's going to grow, isn't it? If you don't talk about it.
We are meeting on Hackney Downs, opposite Hackney Downs School.
I've talked about an increasingly fascist danger which people in this country must begin to come to grips with. Some people have accused me of using rhetoric which doesn't have any basis in reality. But I think that we'll have to be very serious during these very critical moments. We have to understand that there is indeed a very real danger, menace of fascism in the United States today. I do not think that we have already entered into a period of full-blown fascism, because fascism is not something that suddenly explodes and erupts into being. If we look back into the history of the world, if we look at countries like Germany, Spain, Italy, we see that fascism is a process. It's something that grows and develops. It's like a cancer. It starts attacking one group of people, but like a cancer, it begins to spread out with a fatal rapidity, and eventually, like a cancer, it destroys everything around it. Once fascism does consolidate itself, and I think again we have to look towards the past, look at those countries where fascism did develop into its full-blown state. Once this happens, there is no possibility of resisting it and defeating it from within. Look at what happened to Germany. Look at Italy. It was always defeated from without. And I would ask you to tell me one thing, if you can conceive of such a fascist order developing in this country, who would liberate us? Who would be able to liberate a country whose government possesses enough weaponry and enough nuclear capability to destroy every single person in the world many times over? And I know many of you probably do not agree with me that we are embarking upon a period which could lead in the direction of fascism, but I would urge upon you to weigh what I'm going to say very seriously, because your fate may very well depend upon it. If we look to fascist countries in the past, one of the things that becomes very clear is that the government or the class in power has always sought ways and means to divide the people.
love the people.
And you're going to have to keep on saying that. You're going to have to say that I am a proletarian. I am the people. I'm not the pig. You've got to make a distinction. And the people are going to have to attack the pig. The people are going to have to stand up against the pig. So we say, we always say to Black Panther Party that they can do anything they want to us. We might not be back. I might be in jail. I might be anywhere. But when I leave, you can remember I said with the last words on my lips that I am a revolutionary.
America's doomed. America is definitely doomed. There's nothing America can do to save herself. She's doomed economically. She's doomed politically. She's doomed intellectually. She's doomed morally. She's doomed spiritually. And it is only a matter of time before you will see America go up in smoke, up in flames.
There's no such thing as a peaceful revolution. There's no such thing as a bloodless revolution. There's no such thing as a non-violent revolution.
Thank you. time to victory.
City, somewhere in America. You are sitting up this long,
organized nation.
Thank you.
جميع الناس أحرارا متساوين في الكرامة والحقوق، وقد وهبوا عقلا وضميرا، وعليهم أن يعامل بعضهم بعضا بروح الأخاء. لكل فرد الحق في الحياة والحرية وسلامة شخصه. لا يجوز القبض على أي إنسان أو حجزه أو نفيه تعسفا.
Everyone has the right to life, liberty, and security of person. No one shall be held in slavery or servitude.